Good morning, students. Today we are going to see Unit 7 Prose, A Birthday Letter. It is written by Jawaharlal Nehru. About the author, Jawaharlal Nehru was born on 14th November 1889. He was the first Prime Minister of India. He is the main character. He is a central character in Indian politics before and after independence. He appeared as an important and famous leader of independence. So during that independent movement, the freedom movement, so he is under the instruction, he is under Mahatma Gandhi. Being Prime Minister of India, he served people until his death 1964. So he died on 27 May 1964. So until that he helped and served people. He worked for the welfare of the people. He is considered as the founder of, he is the one who founded the modern Indian nation state as a ruler. So he acted as a ruler, socialist, non-religious and democratic, and as well as a democratic republic. He was also known as Pandit Nehru, and the Indian children knew him as Uncle Nehru. Earlier days, letters were the popular mode of personal communication. So it is a written message sent by one person to another. So whatever they want to discuss or talk, they used to write letters. The lesson, A Birthday Letter, is a letter written by Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru to his daughter Indira. So he wrote this letter on her 13th birthday. So it was during summer of 1928. He wrote this letter when he was in Naini jail. In his letter, he speaks to his daughter about languages, trade, history, geography, science, epics and evolution. So those letters contained things which he understood about the world. So understood about what's happening in the world, how the people are living. So all those things included. So for 4 years he wrote letters continuously to his daughter from prison. So being in jail, he wrote many letters to his daughter. Even while in prison, he wanted to guide his child with good teaching and show his love for her. So being in jail, he wanted his daughter to grow up as a good human being. So he wrote many letters to her. Nehru wrote many letters from various prisons in British India to his daughter Indira. Those letters were published in 1942. So during 1942, those letters were published as a book called Glimpses of World History. So it is a collection of 196 letters on world history. So he has written 196 letters to his daughter being in jail. So all those letters were published as a book. Here they have given us one among those letters which is written by Jawaharlal Nehru to his daughter Indira. So Jawaharlal Nehru started the letter by representing her as my dear Indira. So on the day of her birthday, she used to receive many gifts and blessings and good wishes from everyone. So this father, Jawaharlal Nehru, also used to gift many things to her and as well as blessings. But Pandit Nehru was imprisoned in Naini jail. So being in jail, he was not able to send a gift to Indira. So he sends her a letter. Okay. So he said that it is not a solid gift. So it is not a thing. It's just a letter. Okay. So he sends his good wishes through this letter as a present that can be from mind and spirit. So he writes this letter, whatever he feels to say to his daughter. Even the high walls of the prison cannot stop such a spiritual gift. So being in jail, he is not able to gift anything to her. But he is writing a letter which is from his heart, from bottom of his heart. So that the walls of the prison can't be able to stop such a gift. Here, Nehru calls her daughter as his sweetheart. Nehru never believed in sermonizing. Sermonizing means giving moral advice. Also distributing out good advice. So he doesn't like giving moral advice. Okay. So according to him, the best way to find out what is right and what is wrong, what should be done and what should not be done, is by talking and discussing. So we have to decide things by talking and discussing. We should not take any action or any we should not judge anything without talking or discussing. So it can't be solved by hearing advice. It can be solved by discussing. Whenever we discuss, we can solve many problems. Okay, so when we discuss, sometimes a little bit of truth comes out. He mentions that he liked to talk with Indira. Not only that, they both have discussed many things. The world is wide and far away from it. The world is wonderful and strange. He says that the world is very wonderful as well as a mysterious world, a strange world. So, discussing is the right process through which we learn everything. Worth learning and become very clever. So he is not giving any advice, but he writes this letter as if he is discussing with his daughter. So he says that don't take any judgment or any decision before talking or discussing with others. So if there is any problem with anyone else, we have to talk and discuss with them. So without discussing, we can't able to come to a judgment. So whenever we used to judge, okay, whenever we used to judge anyone, we have to discuss and talk with them. So sometimes we may listen something which is true with them. So after that, we can take decisions or judgment. So that is a right thing. He says that letter is one-sided talk, but he asked her to take the messages from the letter as a conversation held between them. So he asked her to think that he is talking, sitting nearby her. So he asked her to take this letter as a conversation, not as a one-sided letter. So in history, we have read about nations, great periods, and about men and women. So we have read many things about the leaders, the kingdoms, about the nation, and about great incidents. So some incidents and some personalities fascinate us and inspire us. It attracts us. It makes us to think many. So ordinary people are not usually heroic, and they are selfish, self-centered people. Okay, normal people are always self-centered people. They just think about their work, their children, their economic condition, household works, and about their worries, and so on. So they won't able to think beyond that. They are always selfish to think about themselves and their family. But when time comes, they become interested in history for some purpose. So whenever they come to know about this history, about the leaders, about the people who lived in the past, okay, they get interested and involved in history for some purpose, for some need. So when those people show interest in history, okay, it helps ordinary men and women to become heroines. Okay, great people, that means to do great things. So great leaders have many good qualities in them. So we have learned many things about the great leaders. So they have said about their good qualities. Okay, so which inspire all the people and makes them to do great things. So such things makes them to do great things. So in India, great leaders like Mahatma Gandhi had many good qualities in them that made people to follow them. So we all know about this history. Okay, so we have learnt many things in history about the kingdom, leadership, great leaders and all. So one among that Indian great leader is Mahatma Gandhi. So he is having many good qualities within him, which make people to follow him. So Gandhiji helped the people who suffered with great love. So he voluntarily helped people. He helped them with full heart. So he is not a selfish man. Okay. So he sacrificed his life and made great things for common good. So not for his good. He did everything for the common good. That quality inspired the people. So the people started loving him. He helped poor people who remain without food and freed the people who are treated cruelly. He made them to live freely and happily. So he gave chances to live very happy. He freed them from their cage, and he also fed people with food. Here he calls Mahatma Gandhi as Bapuji. When he was in prison, that means in jail, okay, his wonderful messages has reached people. It entered into millions of people's heart. Those wise messages entered into people's heart. So those messages made men, women, and even little children to come out of their shells, to come out of their restricted places, so that they become soldiers of freedom. So during this great drama, so he says this history as drama, that is during our struggle for freedom. Okay, he mentions the time of freedom. So many people like Nehru and Indira were likely to witness the happenings before their eyes. So they were the witness. So they saw many things which happened around them during the freedom struggle. Okay, so he mentions them as lucky people who witnessed. So who have seen all the happenings during that freedom struggle. They also took some part to play a role in that great drama of history. So this Nehru and Indira are also a part during that freedom struggle. So if people, he says that if people want to be India's soldier, they have to respect in India's honesty and truthfulness. So now he is talking about India's honesty and truthfulness. So if we want to become a soldier, we have to respect. So such a respect, honor is like a holy thing to believe in truth and trust. So we have to respect our India as a holy thing. Okay, so generally it is not very easy to decide what is right and what is wrong. So now he says that if you want to decide which is right and which is wrong, he asked Indira to apply one little test. So whenever she want to clarify a doubt, he asked him to apply a little test. He asked her never to do anything as a hidden activity. Okay, you should not hide anything from that opinion, from that place. Okay, he asked her not to hide anything. If she hide anything, she is afraid. If he hide anything, means your fear of something. So fear was a bad and unworthy thing of Indira. So if you want to do anything, if you are having any doubt, you should not hide anything from your point of view. You must be very clear. So if you hide anything means you are having some fear in it. So that is an unworthy thing. So Nehru asked her to be brave. He encouraged her to be a brave girl. And here he writes about freedom movement which held under Babuji's leadership, that is Mahatma Gandhi's leadership. He said that there is no space for secrecy or to hide things or thoughts. So there is no space, there is no room for secret things. Okay, there is nothing to hide between them. So everything was open and frank. So there is nothing to hide, and they used to be very open and frank to each other. So if they feel anything, they used to frankly spoke to each other. People were not afraid of what they did and what they said, because they are always honest, they are always truthful. So they are not having any feel of afraid. There is nothing to feel afraid. Even in their private life, they made friends with the sun and worked in the light and did not do anything secretly. So everything is open. So under the sun means everything is open in between them. They didn't hide anything. There is no secret things. Okay. So Nehru assured Indira that if she followed his suggestions, okay, if she follow all those things which he said, at any cost, she might grow up a child of the light. So unafraid, calm, peaceful, and need not worry or get nervous about things which is happen and which happens further. So he wants his child to live a happy life, to live a peaceful life. So for that, he asks her to follow his suggestions. He says the word suggestion, not an advice. So advice is different from suggestion. So he wants his child to follow his suggestions to make her life a happy one. So if she follow all his suggestions, she will live a happy and peaceful life. So she need not worry about things happened or what are the things going to happen. So Nehru said that he have written a very long letter, still he feels to tell more things to her. Okay, so still he feels to tell many things to her, but already it is a long letter. Okay, but in a letter he can't able to deliver whatever he feels. So Nehru wished Indira to grow up into a brave soldier in India's service. He finished his letter with love and good wishes to his little daughter. So he writes this letter as a suggestion letter, not an advice. So finally, Jawaharlal Nehru was not only a famous leader, a great leader, he is also a best father.